This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com. Today we're going to talk about the association of estrogen dominance as a phenomena and its relationship to breast cancer. Now, before we can understand that relationship, we have to back up and understand what estrogen dominance really is. In the female, the balance between two critical female hormones called estrogen and progesterone is very, very important. The estrogen in the body is normally being balanced by progesterone. So the estrogen-progesterone ratio has to be in perfect shape for us to feel good. Now, if we are exposed to an environment, either by external means or internal means, where the estrogen level goes up, or where the progesterone goes down much more than the estrogen, then the ratio between estrogen and progesterone will therefore increase significantly. In other words, if you have a certain level of estrogen and a certain level of progesterone, they usually balance each other. So if the estrogen level goes up, then you have a phenomenon called estrogen dominance. This can happen if you take in excessive estrogen from external sources, such as hormones from animals that is fed, a growth hormone, as well as other chemicals that both boost the estrogen level. It can also cause by estrogen level that's increased in the body because you're taking in more estrogen from petroleum sources such as plastic, shampoos, and nail polishes, etc. They all fall into class of petroleum byproducts called xenoestrogen because they behave estrogenically. So in other words, if the estrogen level goes up, then you have a situation called estrogen dominance. At the same time, if you have progesterone level goes down significantly more than what it should and is not able to balance, therefore, if you have low progesterone, then even though your estrogen level can stay the same or even reduce, the fact that progesterone level drops so much more create an estrogen dominant situation. So in either way, the body will recognize this as increases estrogen. Well, what does it do? Estrogen dominance is a condition where itself will help many of the estrogen-sensitive cells to grow. Well, what are the estrogen-sensitive cells? They include the ovaries, the endometrium, the breast, etc. So classically, you can have fibrocystic breast disease, polycystic ovaries, endometriosis, uterine fibroids, and ultimately breast cancer. So that is one strong association. And indeed, we have known now that excessive estrogen can cause cancer in the breast. So that connection is very strong. Now, don't forget that estrogen is also made in the ovaries as well as the adrenal gland. So if you are under a lot of stress, your adrenal is going to work hard and then your estrogen level is going to go up. Similarly, if you have a diet that's very high in sugar, and you may have cysts in your ovaries, and your ovarian system may be putting out more estrogen as well. So it is very important to understand that estrogen dominance can lead to breast cancer as part of what we call the estrogen dominance continuum. So resolving the root problem, which is excessive estrogen, is a key to prevent breast cancer. Or if you already have breast cancer, is to be able to help to support the body so it stops the cancer cells from going further by depriving the cancer cells of estrogen, which it likes to grow upon and thrive upon. So this is a very important concept, and I hope that you'll be able to recognize this and understand that excessive estrogen in our environment as well as from our body is not a good thing. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.